You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show, where we talk all about elevating your document management with Azure AI Document Intelligence with my friend Bema. Make sure you tune in. Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI Show. We're talking all about elevating your document management with Azure AI Document Intelligence with my friend Bema. How you doing, my friend?
I'm doing great. How are you?
Great. So tell us who you are and what you do.
Yes, I am a product manager on the Azure AI Document Intelligence team, and I'm super excited to show you what we've brought to our new public preview.
All right, so Azure AI Document Intelligence sounds new to me. It's not a product I've heard about. Can you fill me in?
Yes, you are exactly correct. So the first thing I'd actually like to discuss is the rename. We are now the product formerly known as Form Recognizer. We now go by Azure AI Document Intelligence, and we didn't just change the name because it looks better on paper. We made this change because we believe that the new name more accurately represents what our product does now and what we plan to do in the future. We don't just deal with forms. We deal with all types of styles of documents, both structured and unstructured. And our goal is to empower our customers to be able to do more with their documents and enable powerful document understanding use cases. And with our most recent public preview, we have taken another big step in continuing to reach this goal. So you will notice that in this new studio, this change has been already reflected, and that's both in the naming in the studio and also in our URL, which is now documentintelligence.ai.azure.com/studio.
Lovely.
So if you're ready, let's just hop in and look at what's new in this new preview.
Let's do it. So now that I know, and this is cool, now I know that this is, it used to be called Form Recognizer, but now it's Azure AI Document Intelligence. The Document Intelligence Studio has a new URI and everything. So what are some of the new things? Because we've done a lot of Form Recognizer, but I bet there's also new stuff in here as well.
There's a lot of new stuff. So let's start with layout, actually. Awesome. So we have made many changes to the layout model to make working with LLMs easier for our customers. So layout now supports office document types such as PowerPoint and Word documents, as well as different document types we already supported, including digital and scanned PDFs, and all types of image files. So you now have more options than ever when uploading documents and can parse all this data with a single API call.
That's cool.
The Azure AI Document Intelligence layout model offers a comprehensive solution by providing advanced content extraction and document structure analysis capabilities. With this model, you can easily extract paragraphs, tables, titles, section headings, selection marks, font style, key value pairs, math formulas, QR codes, barcodes, reading order, so many things.
That is quite the list.
Yeah, quite the list indeed. And all of this in 309 printed languages and 12 handwritten languages. So if we just run this here.
Hold on. You said that, like, you could basically extract anything.
Exactly.
In any language. Because you said 309 languages. You said that so fast. 309 languages.
309 printed languages and 12 handwritten languages. And we're constantly adding to this list.
That is cool. All right. So what are we looking at?
So what you see here is some new analyze options for layout. And what you'll notice here is that Markdown is a new output format style. So Markdown is extremely popular with web applications and LLM tooling. And so now if I select this and I run the analysis, we will see that the output is now in Markdown, which is extremely easy to integrate in other applications that use LLM technology.
Yeah, and this is really cool. I mean, not to interrupt you here, but this is really cool because I'm able to do this as an intermediate step. I'll put Markdown and put it directly into like an LLM call, for example, which is really cool.
Exactly. And this helps to enable really powerful scenarios with semantic chunking or like RAG scenarios. And in fact, I want to jump to a little application that we've made to actually show some of the power behind what this can enable. So what you'll see here is a little application that we spun up very quickly. But basically, behind the scenes, we're using layout from Azure AI Document Intelligence. And we've used that to create semantic chunks that make it easier for the model to understand what it's looking at. So now the model has better insights into table structure. It understands sections better. As you can see, this is a press release for the fiscal year 24. It understands a lot of context a lot better than if we were not running this with layout behind. So now because of this, it enables me to ask more specific questions. For example, let's ask this model, can you summarize what constant currency is?
So as this is executing, is this literally calling Azure AI Document Intelligence, pulling in the page, is it, it's breaking it up too, and then it's putting that in the, is that what it's doing? Or maybe explain what it's doing, that way I can get a sense.
Yeah, so if you look at the structure of what's been pulled out from this document, for example, you'll see that this, it's able to recognize the different paragraphs, the different section headings, break them into different semantic chunks, and label them. So what this does, when this data is given to a large language model, it's able to use this semantic chunking in order to gain better understanding of exactly what is in the document. That's and this cool. helps because it also does things like maintains reading order. So all of these extra benefits allow the model to have a better understanding of exactly what it is looking at and therefore give better results.
And that's what we're seeing in this application here that you're showing, where you're typing in questions and it's referring to the document.
Exactly. And because it has such a deeper understanding of what is going on in the document, it's able to provide much better answers.
This is amazing. And these questions, like I said, this is cool stuff. Can you do another question I have is, can you do a little bit more? Because there's other LLM technologies that people have been using. Can this integrate with that? Or is this application available, or how can I make something like this?
I am so glad that you mentioned that. So if you are familiar with a lot of LLM technology, you've probably heard of LangChain.
Oh, yes.
LangChain is one of the most popular LLM orchestration tools used to create LLM applications. And we are soon going to have native support for Azure Document Intelligence as a document loader. Ooh. So one of the really cool things I wanted to show off was all of this will be available soon, I promise you, in the next week or so. But you'll be able to quickly, with a few lines of code, go in, set up the LangChain, and then you will be able to load and semantically split different chunks and ask questions using RAG pattern. And we're really excited to see how our customers are able to integrate LangChain and Azure OpenAI in order to do this process.
That's cool. Can we scroll up a little bit? Because I thought I saw Azure AI Search as well. Is that true?
Yes. So Azure AI Search is part of the packages that are included in this demo, but there are many different ways to do this. This is just one way to quickly get off the ground with using LangChain and Azure OpenAI to create these powerful workflows.
And this is cool because I don't know, if you're building LLM stuff, it's usually hard to like figure out how to do the chunking window, because it's like, do I take the first N characters or how do I overlap? But what Azure AI Document Search is doing is it's semantically chunking the data into, for example, reasonable paragraphs, which I think is really cool. Am I getting this right?
So what we're doing is we're providing a very good basis to be used in semantic chunking algorithms. So the output of layout can be fed into these semantic chunking algorithms to provide very easy, basically good data to be used to create strong chunks. We all know in AI, if you put garbage in, you're gonna get garbage out. So basically true. What layout does is it makes sure that we provide high quality data to these semantic chunking algorithms so that when you are using them, you're getting good quality data out when you're implementing these RAG patterns. Cool. So that's the layout stuff, and we're super excited to see how people implement that into their workflows.
What else you got, my friend?
One of my favorite things, one of the features I'm really excited about, I really want to show off, is query fields. And let's jump into the studio so I can show you how that works.
Okay.
So we're going to look at the invoice model here. One of the biggest complaints that we've gotten about our pre-built models is that sometimes they are not sufficient enough for some customer use cases. Now, don't get me wrong, the pre-built models are amazing. They require no training, they require no labeling, and customers are able to use them out of the box. But sometimes we have customers with specific use cases that need a little bit more than we offer. So let's take this UK invoice, for example. If I'm to run this, we're gonna see all the fields that our customers are used to seeing in the invoice pre-built model. Mm-hmm. We have things like customer address, customer address recipient, customer ID, all that good stuff. But let's say, for example, in this specific use case, we have a customer that needs more. So they need the campaign number. They need the sort code and let's say the account number. These fields are not fields that we extract out of the box because most of our customers don't need this information. But in the case that they do, we now have an answer for them, and that's query fields.
I see. So generally the model is very good at a preset, like general stuff for invoices, but there may be specific things for invoices for your organization, for example, that you want to extract, and this is what this does.
Exactly. Okay. And we're never going to be able to cover all of those use cases out of the box, but this mm-hmm. creates a very easy way for customers to add this to their solution. So you'll notice this new pretty button right here called query field. So if I select this, basically what we're going to do here is we are going to use camel case style naming to name the new fields that we want to extract. So for example, we said campaign was one that we wanted to extract. So I'm going to select that and then also sort code. So again, just using very simple camel case style naming. And then let's just add one last one. Let's say account number. Cool. So now when I just have to click that I acknowledge that I am using query fields, save that. And now when I run this analysis again, what we should see is boom, campaign is extracted. We have sort nice. Code and we have account number. And all of this is beautifully integrated directly into the model to common names. So customers can now use these fields in their solution.
I mean, that's cool because I mean, there's gotta be bound to be stuff that you want to pull out that you can totally just put that in there. Is that something you can do programmatically as well? You don't have to show us, but I bet, is that something you can do like in the post request as well?
Exactly. That is exactly the case.
All right. Those query fields were awesome because it enables folks to actually pull stuff, exactly the stuff out that they want. What else you got to show us, my friend?
Yeah. So let's now jump into the custom classification model. Okay. Custom classification models basically allow customers to run a group of documents through a model and be able to instantly tell which documents are in there based off of classification that they themselves have made.
Oh, that's cool, because then you can chain these things to pull out the right forms. Now, and then do other things. Like, for example, if one form has a custom field, then you would want to be able to know that's the right form, and then you could do the other form. And then the other question I had about this, because I heard about this before, if there's a multi-page document that has multiple different kinds of forms in there, does that work as well?
Yes, so you are able to classify whatever it is that you want to do. So let's say that we have a form that has three different types of forms in it, forms A, B, and C, uh-huh. but they're all one collective. If you wanted to split these, split them into their respective parts, you could do this as well. You just have to train the classification model to represent document A, B, and C, and then it would work just like that.
All right, can you show us how to do that?
Yeah, so the custom classification model has actually been expanded to different languages, and one of these is French. So I've set up a demo here just to show how this could work. I've actually pre-set this up just for the sake of time, but it's extremely easy. All you have to do is upload a folder which has two different subfolders, one holding document type A in this case, which is medical healthcare type documents, and then folder B, which has professional service type documents. And then the service will actually split these for you automatically and use the folders as labels, which is why we have this nice stratification without having to do this manually.
That's cool.
Yeah. So once you're done with this, you're going to hit train. And again, I've done this just for the sake of time, because it does take a little bit of time. And what this is going to do is it's just going to generate labels and everything so that it understands what the document structure. And once you have a trained model, mm-hmm. you can go ahead and test it. So that's what we're going to do now. We're going to go to test, and I'm going to browse for a file, and let's choose this sample file and run the analysis. And what we should see here is the model being able to tell which bucket this belongs to. And we do. So we have this being recognized as a professional service document.
And that's super cool, because now you're able to have any number of different kinds of documents. You're able to have document intelligence tell you what kind it is, maybe even break apart a multi-page document. And then you can process those things with custom fields for each kind of document. So you really got like a really powerful end-to-end solution.
Okay. I know I said that this was last thing, but we actually have, I have one more thing that I want to go over.
There's a couple
of small updates that we've made to the service, if that's okay. Awesome. So the first thing that I want to point out is that with the Read API, we've actually added support for handwritten extraction for the languages of Russian, Arabic, and Thai. We're really excited about this. You know, we have customers all over the world. And so these were some really highly requested languages, and we're excited to announce that those are now available for you to try in the studio today. We also have new pre-built models. So US tax documents is an area that we've been investing a lot of resources into, and we're happy to announce that we now have available the US tax 1099 forms in all of these variations as well. Again, these empower very powerful scenarios. These 1099 forms are things that people use for taxes every year. So we're really excited to see how our customers can use this to make their document intelligence processing even easier.
Yeah, and just in time for tax season too.
Exactly.
That's cool.
That was not a mistake. along with this, in the invoice model actually, we've added support for KVK number, which is a critical field in the Dutch locale. We've also added support for BPAY information, which is critical in the Australian locale. And with these changes, we now more fully support these locales, and we hope that this will allow customers in those locales to have more robust solutions without having to rely on things like custom models.
That's cool.
And then the last update that we have here is in health insurance cards. We now have support for Medicare and Medicaid numbers built into the health insurance card model. And again, we just are very excited to see how this empowers customers to have more robust solutions that allow them to do more with their document intelligence needs.
Yeah, and this is cool because it could even be a picture. So you could build applications where, like, let's just say you're a medical place and it's just like, here, just pull your card under our camera and then boop. Azure AI Document Intelligence can make that sing if I get it right. Am I getting this right?
You are getting this right. And that is one of my favorite things about this service is how robust it is. I even remember when I first joined the team, I drew out an invoice with my hand on plain white paper, and it was able to extract all the information correctly. It's amazing how far this technology has come.
That is amazing. So this has been awesome. Where can people go to find out more?
Yeah, so the first place to go would be Azure Document and the Azure Document Intelligence Studio. Here you can find resources that will help you get up and started very quickly and allow you to test out all of our services right here in the studio. Another good place to go would be our documentation. We keep all the information up to date with what's coming, what's new, and there'd be another great place for you to check out what we have coming through the pipeline.
Well, this has been amazing, my friend. Thank you so much for spending some time with us.
Thank you so much for having me. It's been awesome. A blast.
And also, thank you so much for watching and learning all about elevating your document management with Azure AI Document Intelligence here on the AI Show. Thank you so much for watching, and hopefully we'll see you next time. Take care.